I'm Betty. Welcome to Betty's Kitchen. Today we're making squash casserole, and I'm doing this in response to a request from one of my subscribers. And if you came with me on my trip to the farmer's market, I actually bought the squash there. And I have it right here. I bought some yellow summer squash, and I got some green zucchini. All I've done at this point is just wash these, and I tried to dry them off a little bit. I think I'll dry them a little bit more, and then I will cut off the ends, and I will dice them. Here's what I got when I diced the yellow summer squash and the green zucchini. Cups of each kind of squash. I would like to say that these squash are young and tender, and they do not need to be peeled. That's why you see the peelings are in here, as well as the meat of the zucchini and the yellow squash. We're going to saute this in oil, and it's going to take quite a long time for it to actually get really soft, but it's important that you cook it all the way through. So the first step in our squash casserole is to have some oil back here heating. I just turned it on, but it's probably not heated up yet. I used 1 tablespoon of extra virgin olive oil. You can use any kind of cooking oil that you like, or use butter or margarine. And then empty out your 2 cans of zucchini, 2 cups of zucchini, and your 2 cups of yellow summer squash. And then we'll just be stirring that around and cooking it. This is what your squash looks like when it is sauteed. It's nice and soft, and it did take 20 minutes for it to get to this point. So don't undercook it, or you may have some crunchiness in your casserole that you don't want. So I'm removing this from the stove. I've already turned it off, and I'm coming over here to a colander that I have lined with paper towel. And the paper towel is there to just absorb any excess oil that might be there. And also I'm going to use it to squeeze out some juice. All right, the next step is to go back to our skillet, which has used up its tablespoon of extra virgin olive oil. Replace that. Just pour in an estimate of 1 tablespoon. And then start heating that. And into that is going to go 1 chopped onions. You just need an onion like this. I used a kitchen chopper, and I'm going to need something to get that out with. That goes into our olive oil. If you can have your olive oil hot, that's nice. It doesn't really matter in this case whether it is or not. It is beginning to sizzle. That's fine. This is what your 1 onion looks like once it is chopped up and sauteed in that 1 tablespoon of olive oil. So you want to go for about 5 minutes to get that. Now let me bring over our squash. I've had it here draining, and I've also done some squeezing on it. And you'll see that what we'll have is mainly the pulp of the squash, and we won't have any extra liquid. So a lot of that has gone into the paper towel, so we're going to put the good stuff, the squash, in with our onions. So that way we're not picking up a lot of extra liquid and making a watery casserole. This is going to be delicious. Stir this together just a little bit. And then our next item that comes along is sour cream. I chose fat-free sour cream. Choose whatever you like. You need 1/3 of a cup. I just got that. As I move down the line here, I've got some sharp cheddar cheese, and I'm using 3/4 cup. So our seasonings are right here. We need some salt, and I just have a shaker that I use at the stove or at the table. Just a dash of salt, whatever is to your taste. I'm not going to say a specific amount. And then black pepper. This is ground black pepper. Just going to shake some of that in. The third seasoning I have is garlic powder. So I'm just going to put a little here. This wants to run very freely, so I'm going to be very careful and not overdo it. But we want that little zing that it's going to give. So just to your taste on those 3 spices. And then we're going to get this all mixed up. And we're gonna put it in a buttered dish. In my case, I use cooking oil spray, canola oil, and I sprayed the thing entirely. And I chose a deep dish pie plate. So I'm just going to slide this in, and then I'm gonna make a topping for it before I get ready to put it in the oven. So let me spread this out just a little bit so you can see what it looks like before the topping. Then we'll come back and I'll make the topping and place it on there and get this going. I'm ready to make the topping for our squash casserole, and I'm using Ritz crackers and also some butter. The Ritz crackers, you know, come in tubes like this, and I emptied out one tube and put it in a Ziploc bag, gallon size. And if you've watched my videos, you know I do that quite often. If I want to make any kind of crumbs, then I use a rolling pin and just go over it until they are as fine as I want. So what I'm going to do is pour some of these out into a little pie dish here. And what I'm looking at is the mixture of the melted butter with the crumbs. And I want to get it to look just right. Something about like that. It needs to be crumbly where you can pick it up with your hands and sprinkle it over the top. And that's just what I'm going to do. Over the top of the squash casserole, we're going to have crumbs going all around evenly. And we're going to put this in a 350 degree oven and let it bake for maybe 25 to 30 minutes. I'll keep track of the time and I'll let you know how long it is baked. But it's going to make a beautiful squash casserole. The squash casserole is done. I've been checking on it and it took 15 minutes. Actually, it did not take very long because this is a very small portion. You can see it's not a big casserole. I would suggest if you have a lot of people to feed, you might want to double all of the amounts and make a casserole in a dish that is maybe a 13 by 9 by 2, and that would take you a little more time to cook. But this one was done, you could tell by the bubbling up of the casserole and also the browning of the topping. I want to let you see what the texture looks like, so I'm just going to dip in here and we'll get some of this good squash and all of that goes with it. And the topping too. See what it looks like? All you people out there that think squash is a very bland food, well, it just depends on how you prepare it. If you put a little sour cream and cheddar cheese with it, a nice topping like that, I think you'll like it.